From Tomar Naam, Amar Naam, Vietnam to Jai Shri Ram. If one were to trace the political history of Bengal over the last six decades in a sentence, that is what it would be. Lord Ram has assumed an unforeseen importance in the state recently, throwing up many questions. Like, is Jai Shri Ram a part of Bengali ethos? Is it a BJP import? And most importantly, Ram ke naam sunke Mamta Didi ko itna gussa kyun aata hai? Let's tackle the first question first. Does Ram or Ram worship have a history in Bengal? Well, yes and no. To begin with, the Durga Puja that we celebrate in the state is called Okal Bodhon. Roughly translated, it means the worship of Durga at an uncustomary time. It refers to the invocation of the goddess by Lord Ram in the month of Ashwin, as opposed to the customary time, which is the Basant season, in order to seek blessings before he had his showdown with Ravan. Bengal also has a very rich Vaishnav tradition. Ram and Krishna have both been worshipped as incarnations of Lord Vishnu. However, Krishna worship remained more popular due to the work of Vaishnav saints like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So while Janmashtami has historically been a part of the Taro Parbon or 13 festivals of the Bengali calendar, Ram Navami remained a private festival celebrated mostly by non-Bengali Hindus. There are also shrines of Lord Ram in places like Medinipur, Nodia and Howrah, and there has also been a Bengali version of the Ramayana written by Krittibhash Ojha in the 15th century. Literature too saw mentions of Ram, one of the most popular being Michael Madhusudan Dutta's Meghnad Bodh Kavya, which portrayed Ram as an anti-hero to Ravan. However, the predominant Hindu tradition here is that of Shaktiism, or the worship of the Devi in her various forms. Durga, Kali, Santoshima, etc. have therefore evolved as the main forms of deity worship in West Bengal. The most often used greeting here therefore is Joy Ma Kali or Joy Durga and not Jai Shri Ram. Does this mean that Ram doesn't exist in Bengal at all? No. Does it mean that Ram Navami was not one of Bengal's most celebrated festivals? Yes. Was it because Hindu festivals have been marginalized? No. Now coming to the next question. Is Ram a BJP import in Bengal? No. But is the celebration of Ram Navami with kids marching with swords a BJP phenomena? Absolutely. Many believe that the watershed moment for the party in Bengal was the Ram Navami of 2017 when it decided to celebrate the festival. This celebration saw people, including children in school uniform, march the streets with swords and other weapons. The imagery shook Bengal. But the argument made was, why are you not devastated when the same thing happens year after year during Muharram? This was followed by a larger celebration in 2018, which saw communal clashes in places like Asansol and Purulia, in which three people lost their lives. Soon after, Jai Shri Ram became the BJP's rallying cry in Bengal, just like it is Bharat Mata Ki Jai in other parts of the country. The seculars called it aggressive communalization, but the voters... Well, the voters said what they had to say. Which brings us to the third question. Why does Jai Shri Ram trigger Mamta Didi so much? Well, let's just say Jai Shri Ram is to her now what leftist unions, students of President's University and all things red were to her before 2014. Just like she called students Maoists in 2012 when they asked her tough questions, she now calls anyone chanting Jai Shri Ram a criminal and an outsider. Ram is how the BJP won 18 seats in Bengal and Didi quite clearly will have none of him around. Now, in what seems like an afterthought, the BJP has modified its Ram slogan to also include Jai Ma Kali in order to counter Mamta's attempts of branding the party anti-Bengali. Also tired of beating each other up, both parties have now decided to inundate the other with postcards bearing religious slogans. Meanwhile, the pantheon of Hindu gods are now on standby, wondering who will be called on next to do some political bidding.